proboscis monkey or the scientific name Nalasis rebatus or long nose monkey is a monkey with unusual large nose, a reddish brown skin color, and a long tail. It is endemic to the Southeast Asian island of Borneo, and it is found mostly in mangrove forests and on the coastal area of the island. Proboscis monkey generally lives in groups composed of one elder male, some elder female, and their offspring. The proboscis monkey is endemic to the island of Borneo and can be found in three nations that divide the island, which is Brunei, Indonesia, and Malaysia. It is common in coastal area and along rivers. The proboscis monkey is assessed with an endangered species in the IUCN Red List of the threatened species and list in the appendix first of sites.
Hi, my name is Novadila Tumusna, and I'm going to talk about the uniqueness of proboscis monkey. It may seem hard to believe, but male proboscis monkeys use their fleshy, pendulous noses to attract mates. Obviously, they have large noses. Scientists think these outsized organs create an echo chamber that amplifies the monkey's call, impressing females and intimidating rival males. Proboscis monkeys have an unusual trait not seen in many other species of monkey, which they can swim. Using their partially webbed toes and fingers, they are able to escape predators such as crocodile and swim across deep water to find food or maybe escape potential danger on land. Proboscis monkeys are excellent swimmers, but only swim when necessary, as when crossing rivers. Apart from that, proboscis monkeys survive mainly on a diet of leaves, seeds, and unripe fruits, but will occasionally consume insects as well. They have complex, chambered stomachs that rely on a host of symbiotic bacteria for digestion. That's all from me. I will pass it on to the next presenter.
Good morning to our lecturers and my fellow friends. My name is Nasha Farhan Binti Saleh, and I will be presenting about the proboscis monkey's status and threats. Proboscis monkey is classified as endangered by the IUCN in 2015. Numbers of proboscis monkeys remaining in Borneo have fallen in the last 40 years. There are estimated to be fewer than 20,000 of proboscis monkeys remaining in Borneo, comprised of many small and isolated populations. Due to their specific habitat requirements, proboscis monkeys are effectively restricted to forest tribes along rivers in the interlinking waterways of swamp forest and coastal mangrove. Although fires, forest hunting, and illegal wildlife trade are all threats to this proboscis monkey, the major threat is habitat destruction. The rampant clearing of rainforests, especially riverine forests and mangroves in Borneo for timber, palm oil plantation, and settlements has depleted huge regions of the proboscis monkey's habitat. Forest fire along riverbanks also have taken out large area in where proboscis monkey once roamed. Habitat destruction and fragmentation has impacted the distribution of the species. Proboscis monkey are being forced to descend from trees more often and travel long distance for food. Land predators include jaguar and humans, who consider them as delicacy. They are also hunted for bizarre stones found in intestinal secretion, which is used traditionally in the Chinese medication. Even living in protected areas does not guarantee a survival for the proboscis monkeys. Despite an estimated 5,000 of proboscis monkeys living in protected areas, entire populations still losing their habitat and die. The end result was proboscis monkeys began to die, forcing remainder of the populations to move to unprotected areas or zoo where many die en route or following arrival. That's all from me. Thank you.
My name is Rohana Binti Mustamin. I will share you about the conservation recommendation. The first one is translocation of population at risk of local extinction. Translocation is the managed movement of live indigenous animals from one location to another. It covers the entire process including planning, the transfer, release, monitoring, and post-release management. Translocation are commonly used and have been highly successful tool in well-planned endangered species recovery program. Kunak in 2003 cleared these habitat patches and moved them into Labuk Bep Proboscis Monkey Sanctuary. The next one is protecting important proboscis monkey habitats. Immediate action is required to halt the decline of existing habitats. The majority of proboscis monkey are found near coastal areas and rivers where available habitat is decreasing rapidly. Riparian habitats in particular are not sufficiently protected, compounded by the fact that most human settlements are closely associated with river systems. It is important for the responsible party to tighten laws to protect this riparian habitat. The last one is re-establishment of forests and river corridors. Greater efforts must be dedicated to restoring remnant habitat patches as well as re-establishing corridors around fragmented river system. Preferably, linking major population through a protected area network as part of a conservation strategy that extends beyond borders for protection of the species across its range. Sabah Forestry Department should establish and restoring remnant habitat patches, especially river at Kinabatangan, Sugut, and Segama.
Rashida binti Mama Radi. Now I want to talk about awareness. The first one is non-government organization can collaborate with the government to do an awareness campaign about the proboscis monkey. This campaign can be done through the online platform, which is Facebook Live, since now we are in COVID-19 pandemic. This campaign can be focused more to the adults and teenagers. During this campaign, the organizers must emphasize the factors that causes proboscis monkey to become endangered species. The second one is, as a consumer, we have to support and join all the campaigns that been advocated by the government, because this is one of the way that can show we care about endangered species. The another way to keep people aware about endangered species is focusing to the kids. The school authorities can expose the student to the endangered species by bringing them to the zoo or wildlife park. For your information, in Sabah, proboscis monkey can be found in protected areas, which is Klias National Park and Ulu Segama Reserve, so that the student will know what is the species that become endangered and gain knowledge very well about proboscis monkey. That's all from me. Thank you.